नमस्कार, मैं हूं इंद्र मोहन। कांग्रेस नेता राहुल गांधी ने 4 जून को देश के जाने माने उद्योगपति और बजाज ऑटो के मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर राजीव बजाज से कोरोना संकट को लेकर, लॉकडाउन और देश की अर्थव्यवस्था को लेकर वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग पर बात की। वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग के दौरान राजीव बजाज ने कहा कि भारत ने कोविड-19 संकट से निपटने के लिए पश्चिमी देशों की ओर देखा और कठिन लॉकडाउन लगाने का प्रयास किया, जिससे ना तो संक्रमण का प्रसार रुका, उल्टे अर्थव्यवस्था तबाह हो गई। लॉकडाउन से संबंधित सवाल पर उन्होंने कहा है कि दुर्भाग्यवश हमने पश्चिम, खास करके सुदूर पश्चिम की तरफ देखा और पूर्व की तरफ नहीं देखा। उन्होंने कहा, हमने कठिन लॉकडाउन लागू करने का प्रयास किया जिसमें खामियां थी, इसलिए मुझे लगता है कि हमें आखिर में दोनों तरफ से नुकसान हुआ। इस तरह के लॉकडाउन के बाद वायरस मौजूद रहेगा, आप इस वायरस की समस्या से नहीं निपट पाए, लेकिन इसके साथ अर्थव्यवस्था तबाह हो गई।
I like your point about we looked west and not east. Why do you think we looked west?
I guess, as some people say, it's the first time that something like this, as opposed to TB or pneumonia or diarrhea, something as simple as diarrhea that apparently kills 100,000 largely children in India. Here is something that struck in the heart of the developed world. When the rich and famous get affected, it always makes a bigger headline. As someone said in the very early days of this problem, that 8,000 kids die of starvation in Africa every day. Who cares? Beyond the point. In civil society, we are not even aware of this fact. So I think primarily the sensation was because affluent people in developed countries were vulnerable. And perhaps some people inferred ki agar inko aisa ho sakta hai, to phir hum to kahan ke nahin rahe, this kind of feeling. And that is why I have often said to people that, to my mind as a layman, I saw from the beginning that there were 4 choices before us. At one extreme, on the left, if I may say so, is the choice of a hard lockdown, as you said, which implies a almost airtight, impervious lockdown. And to the best of my knowledge, this has not happened anywhere in the world. Because to physically constrain yourself to your home and see absolutely no one. On the other extreme, I would say is, business as usual. Just ignore it, carry on, jo hoga, hoga type of thing. Nobody says this either. So everybody's trying to find a middle path, I think, between these two extremes. I think, unfortunately, India not only looked west, it went to the wild west, I think, in the sense we stayed more towards the impervious side. We tried to implement a hard lockdown, which was still porous. So I think we have ended up with the worst of both worlds. On the one hand, a porous virus makes sure that porous lockdown makes sure that the virus will still exist. And as you said, it is still waiting to hit you when you unlock. So you have not solved that problem. But you have definitely decimated the economy. You flattened the wrong curve. It's not the infection curve, it's the GDP curve. This is what we have ended with, the worst of both worlds. In my view, what should have been done is something more right of center, which is the kind of stuff that we are hearing out of Japan and Sweden. And people, when they hear about this in terms of being articulated as herd immunity, tend to think that herd immunity means, let the vulnerable die. It doesn't mean that at all. They are missing the details, that whether it's in terms of sanitization, masks, distancing, Sweden, Japan, etc., are following all these practices. But they are not trying to go further into the unproductive zone, as you said, and make something that is relatively benign and manageable appear to be fatal and beyond control. So I think, unfortunately, we have a quasi-hard lockdown, I would say, which has given us the worst of both worlds.